Welcome to BBL Beers Day 70. Time is 5:59. Coming up tonight, these fellas have sold over 60 million records and they've still found time to come and join us in the Borehamwood car park. It's Boyz II Men! Oh, my God! And have you ever wondered just how Beth Ditto looks so great? Yeah, me too. Well, the bloke who zips her up is here. Johnny Blue Eyes, everybody. And so much love to give. But first, it's time for BBLB News 25.
BBLB News 25, 24-hour news and then some.
At 8:45 p.m. last night, Angel took it upon herself to tamper with Halfwit's facial hair, quite possibly an experiment to create her ideal lover.
Oh, you look sexy. Oh, God.
Blackbeard.
You look like Brad Pitt.
Brad Pitt.
Look, that's Brad Pitt coming.
That is you, actually.
Yeah. You look like Dostoevsky.
You look like Brad Pitt. You don't look like Brad Pitt at all. Now, after a tumultuous first day of nominations at 9:34 p.m. yesterday, Big Brother provided a distraction with the most whatever task designed to test all facets of the perfect housemate.
Big Brother is looking for the following housemates. One, the strongest housemate. Two, the most intelligent housemate. Three, the most musical housemate. And four, the most patient housemate. The strongest housemate is Marcus. The most intelligent housemate is myself. The most musical housemate is Angel. And the most patient housemate is Lisa. We're ready to go.
Find out what task each housemate was given to prove themselves a little later on. Now, at 3:46 p.m. today, the housemates started getting just a little bit paranoid. Who'd have thought being confined in a small space would do that to people, eh?
If there is a mole, if there is like a secret task, not a mole, if there is a secret task, it would be annoying.
Because her glasses have been on for ages, isn't it? And she keeps getting called to the diary room.
It's not the person you would likely Lisa Smith, I think, Rodrigo.
And in other news, looks like Marcus isn't impressed with the script from the new X-Men film. Wow, look at the power. A halfwit desperately tries to locate a tattoo parlor in his head.
I like guys with tattoos.
And Shri disturbed whilst diving for treasure.
No.
What?
And that's that for the news. Now, if you've got any questions for our guests about the housemates or about the show in general, you know the drill. Get in touch. Call Little Brother's Big Answer and leave a message with your question on 0871 200 1040. Or you can send your question into BBLB by texting studio, followed by your question to 84444. Or you can email us via the website channel4.com/BBLB. And, of course, we'll do our best to answer all your questions throughout the series. Now, as we saw last night, the housemates have finally been allowed access to the rest of the house, everybody! Yeah. So, here's our top five areas of the house that don't exist but should. In at five, ladies and gentlemen, a hatchery so that Angel can have fresh, raw eggs every morning. Not very nice. In at four, a TV room where they can watch the very latest action from the Big Brother house. That's not going to work, is it, actually? In at three, something with a sea view. It will cost a bit more, but it will be well worth it. In at number two, Big Brother boudoir, so Siavesh and K-Run can get a little bit of privacy. How about that? And the number one area of the house that doesn't exist but should, a library so that Carly can brush up on her modern history. The Germans came to Britain. That's why Germans just like English. No, it didn't happen. Didn't happen like that, Princess. Now, my first guests are a multi-Grammy award-winning R&B outfit. They're currently touring the country, but they've reached the end of the road right here. Let's make love to Boyz II Men, everybody! Gentlemen, how we doing? I can't tell you how excited I am.
We're happy to be here.
Oh, well, that's just good news. Now, you've only been in the UK a few days, is that right?
Right. We've been here for about 2 days. We've got another four because we've got some concerts here over the next 2 days.
Okay. Yeah, well, I mean, obviously, concert secondary to Big Brother. That's the main reason.
Course, yeah. Absolutely. Yes, absolutely.
You've
definitely.
Been absolutely glued to it, I'm assuming.
Yeah, well, you know, we travel a lot, but, you know, we're familiar with the show because there's a Big Brother in the United States.
So although
we're
familiar it's different.
With the whole, you know. Although it's different, but, yeah, we, you know.
You get the premise.
Yeah, we got the premise.
Is there anybody you like so far?
Yeah.
You know what?
Yeah,
I kind of like, what's my man name?
I like the dude that's
half-wit.
I like half-wit.
Half-wit and
you like C-Avage,
C-Avage, yeah.
C-Avage, man.
I
like Chiron. I like Chiron.
They pretty much like everybody.
No, you know what?
Really, I like Norton. What's her name? Norin? Norin?
Yeah,
she's nice.
I bet you do.
She's nice.
C-Avage is my dude. I just like his sense of, like,
Sri is weirding me out. Sri is weirding me out.
I like it. If you could just sit here all day, just looking over there. Carly, how do you feel about Carly, guys?
Carly's
nice, but I mean, you expect
Carly,
that.
Carly,
you know?
She's,
but I want to know what he was doing in the tub thingy, the tree.
So we all want to know what he was doing in the tub.
Yeah, that was nasty, dude.
Is it fair to say that you're love gods, essentially, all right? Your music has been the soundtrack to many a romance, I'm right in saying
Yes, we've been told that.
And there's been a lot of flirting going on in the house. I wondered if you could cast your professional eyes over it. We'll watch it and then you assess it for us.
All right, sure.
Fantastic. Watch this.
Your heart is so gold. You're perfect. You're a very nice heart, man. How is your love life? Deep down, your heart is matured like a big tree.
You fancy me? Is that what it is?
No.
Now, the main thing with Sri that I think that I like personally is he's working his way right round the house. There wasn't just one lady.
Too. You can't just stay in one spot. You gotta, you know, spread the wealth a little bit.
Right, okay, and he's definitely doing that. Do you think his approach is working well?
No, I don't think his approach is working at all.
It's a little
simply
lame.
Because he's saying the same
line to the same.
So that's not gonna work.
Yeah, I mean, he's talking about the heart when he's really looking at the boobies.
Yeah. There's nothing wrong with the multiple interaction, you just got to have a different story.
Right, you've got to differentiate.
Right,
maybe some lines from Boys to Men for him.
Yeah,
what would you say?
What I would actually say.
Let's go to Lady One.
It depends on the lady. Like I say, if I was talking to
Norrie. Yeah,
course,
I see what's happening here.
Like, hey,
she's
hey,
running around the
yeah,
circle.
Exactly. Right? How are you? You know what I mean? First, you got to, how are you? You know, what's going on in your mind, you know what I'm saying? You look like you're thinking about something, and you know what I mean? I'd like to know.
I'm just falling into a bit of a trance here.
I mean, because what you really want them to know is that you're listening to them. You want to hear what's going on in their mind.
Right.
Because if you don't know what's going on, you're going to
start
giving
yourself. But if I just walk around
asking
everybody what's going on in your mind, everybody's
starting
to.
Well, see, it's not about everybody.
It's about the women.
Women always want you to know before they know. Like, you've got to be ahead of what they're thinking.
Are they right, ladies? Damn right they are. They're Boys to Men. They're not wrong. By the way, good news, everybody. We've got some exclusive flirting in tonight's show. Dogface and Chris getting very touchy-feely.
Snap.
Gentlemen, would you ever consider going into the house?
Yeah, I'd do it.
Yeah?
They told me to come back in December, so I might be back in December.
All right, fantastic. I don't think you're meant to give that away right now, but I'm glad you have. And now it's a very exciting day for us today because, as we heard earlier on, the housemates took part in the most whatever task to find out who was the strongest, the most intelligent, the most musical, and the most patient housemates. Let's have a look how they got on.
Descartes.
Oh my God.
Oh my God.
That is correct.
Yes.
No, I'm sorry.
Angel, you have made a mistake. Lisa, you have been named the most patient housemate. You must then sit down and await further instructions.
No.
Most patient housemate to the diary room.
Yeah, there we go.
Lisa, Big Brother can confirm that you have successfully proven that you are a truly patient housemate.
Thank you.
Wow. How do you think they did in the task, guys?
Yeah, not bad.
I didn't see him rip the phone book,
though.
No,
he didn't rip the...
He did all right. He did all right. Now, we want to separate the boys from the men. I want you guys to put yourselves forward for the various tasks, if that's all right. Who's the strongest boys to men man?
I'm not the strongest, but I'm going to try it, though.
Really? You're going to go for it? You're going to hand that over, sir?
Yeah.
Right, let's see how this goes.
I'm going to make sure it's not...
It's an official phone book. It's not been tampered with.
Now, how do you rip it? Can you rip it this way?
It's best to try and rip it. Rip there.
Rip here.
Okay, give it. Right, this is the phone directory. Okay, here we go.
Okay.
Oh, come on, Sean. Let's.
There you go. Come on. You got to use your mind.
One at a time.
Use your mind.
It's flying.
Come on. Yeah, he's doing it. Use your brain.
They love how you did that. Who's the most musical? Who's the most musical out of you?
Him.
Right? Okay, I'd like you to play Twinkle, Twinkle, Little Star.
I gotta
okay?
put on C. Start on C.
I gotta put on my, Stevie Wonder glasses.
Start C.
Right here. Right here?
No, he's got it. Yes. Yeah. Good.
Oh! Yeah! Yeah! Go. Go, hold on.
This is amazing. Who'd have thought we'd have boys to men on Little Brother playing Twinkle, Twinkle, Little Star? Right, that means you must be the most intelligent, all right?
Okay.
So I got a question for you.
All right.
How long did your song, I'll Make Love to You, spend at number one in America?
I know it.
Should I answer it? Come on, yeah, answer it. Just answer it.
Wait, keep him in suspense. Like, you know, like, look like you're thinking.
Oh, yeah, you know.
It's just having to think this one through for a minute.
You know, we haven't really had too many hits, so it's kind of tough to...
I know, he's doing his own clock. This is fantastic.
Maybe 14
weeks. 14 weeks, ladies and gentlemen. They don't want to mention it. They don't want to mention it. It's not a big deal for them.
He is smart.
And now the fourth part of the challenge was to find out who the most patient was. But clearly you're very patient, men, for playing along with this nonsense. Thank you very much. Boys to men, ladies and gentlemen. Huh? How about that? Do join us after the break. Johnny Blue Eyes, our new fashion expert, will be coming out of the closet. We'll see you after the ads.
It's all right, it's so dangerous.
Ten. 11, 12, 13, two more, 14,
15. Welcome back to BBLB. It's 6:15. Time now to meet the new BBLB fashion expert, Johnny Blue Eyes. This is him talking about himself.
I like to express myself in many ways. I have worked with the most fantastic, gorgeous angels of New York, the Scissor Sisters, the band The Claxons, and the wonderful Beth Ditto and The Gossip, who I just love. I'm not saying, oh, I'm so fabulous, but I'm saying, yes, I have great taste.
If you're working with an artist,
hello, how are you? Nice to see you. Losing a bit of weight? I'm a cuddly guy.
Johnny loves ya. Come back. Come here!
Johnny Blue Eyes, everybody. Give him a big round of applause. How are we doing, sir? You all right?
Good, thank you.
Johnny, look lovely, ladies. Look at these silver strides, eh?
Brave man
to pull them off.
You've got to turn it out for the people.
You're absolutely right. We're 7 days in. You've had a lot of time to cast your fashion eyes over the people in the house. What are we thinking so far?
We are thinking there's lots of different energies in the house, but we have zoomed in on a couple of different ideas.
Okay, so we've got the people who are getting it wrong first. Who have we got? I'm just going to angle this round a bit more. So we've got our two girls, Dogface and Carly, there. You don't like the look.
I don't. I think people might be surprised by me choosing the two girls, but I think their look is very generic, a sort of rip-off of Paris Hilton. And I think Paris Hilton has got bad style. Yeah. And I think our two girls here...
So they're ripping off bad style.
Badly.
What would you like to see them wear?
I would like to just see them think about doing something that's more creative and as more about them and as individuals rather than cloning themselves to someone like Paris.
Right, now, there's a lot of guys in the audience thinking, well, I don't see what the problem is, really. Yeah. Certainly all the cameramen, anyway. Right, so, and then who's getting it right?
I think Siavash is getting it right, actually.
Your doppelganger?
My doppelganger.
Right, okay.
And look, I know you're going to think how he looks like me and I'm cheesing it, because, but it's not that. I think he really has a great sense of individuality.
Look at that, hat. Did he bring that hat in with him?
He brought it in with him. Isn't it just gorgeous?
He looks fantastic. I have to say, do we like Siavash's style, guys? Yeah, we do. Now, I believe you popped round to meet his mum.
I did.
Yeah? And you had a little rifle through the
Had doors. A little rifle through his wardrobe and had a little look in the house. I did.
Yeah?
And it was... they were really lovely. His family were gorgeous and we had a great experience.
Shall we have a little look in there, see Avesh's cupboard, guys? Yeah.
Hello, how are you? It's nice to meet you.
I'm loving it. I'm so much cousin.
Been very kindly given gorgeous biscuits. I've got a bit stuck in my hair there. Let's go and have a look at the wardrobe. This is fabulous. I'm waiting for the cake. It's gorgeous. Is it working?
Oh my god.
Yeah?
Oh my god.
Looking at this wardrobe, there is an emerging performer in Siavash. Yes, please. I can totally see Mika rocking that. Good for a bit of punk energy on a sleeve.
We need it. We love it.
So showman-tastical, actually. Is it like watching Siavash? Is it like watching him crawling around in his bed? I found a secret normal shelf in the wardrobe. We have some shell-seated bottoms. Siavash, are you a chav on the quiet, my dear? I think YES to these glasses. He might be after my job, actually. He could be dressing pop stars and rock and rollers. It's a thumbs up from Johnny Blue Eyes from Siavash's wardrobe. Definite thumbs up.
Shell suit?
Yes.
Now, in 2009, how dare he?
Well, I'm flummoxed by the idea that I think he's a geezer on the side.
Right, okay.
I think he plays football on a Sunday morning.
Yeah. Oh, Siavash's mum's quite hot, actually. Johnny, whose house do you want to go to next?
I would like to go to Dogface's house next, because I know that people will be shocked by my choice. But maybe I'll be proved wrong, because it's my opinion. But
Do we like Dogface's style? No, they don't like it.
Oh, well, so are you with me, guys?
Yeah.
Good, thank you. All right. Well, let's see if I can be proved wrong.
Give him a big round of applause, Johnny Blue Eyes, everybody.
Thank you.
Now, it is time for a BBLB exclusive. For the first time ever, I can tell you which housemates are facing eviction this week before Big Brother has even told them. Yes. So, either Halfwit or Sophia will be evicted from the Big Brother house on Friday, and you decide who that will be. Here's how to vote. To evict Halfwit, call 09016 16 1605. To evict Sophia, call 09016 16 1614. Calls cost 35p from a BT landline. Other networks may vary. Mobiles will cost considerably more. Details and terms at channel4.com/Big Brother. Voting closes in Friday's eviction show. Now, if you do vote, please make sure you dial very carefully and you can see who nominated who on Channel 4 tonight at 10 o'clock. So, audience, what do we make of that? What about you, sir?
I think Sophia should go.
Really? Oh, no, who shouted that?
I don't think she should go because she's very entertaining.
She is entertaining. Yeah. Anybody else?
She's annoying.
We don't like Sophia. What about Halfwit, anybody? Do you like Halfwit?
Not particularly, no.
No, anybody like Halfwit? Nobody likes Halfwit. What a nightmare. Okay, well, our guests are still here. Let's go and speak to them. We've got Johnny Blue Eyes and Boyz II Men over here. What do we think about that, guys?
Well, we had a little tribunal about it, and we like Halfwit.
What do you think, Johnny?
I quite like him too, actually. I think he needs a little time to just develop.
Bed in
these,
a little bit.
Yeah, just get in there.
I've got to be honest, because I was sitting over there, obviously, watching you guys. Johnny came and sat down. I know you were clocking some of the style. Do you think maybe there's going to be some partnership between Boyz II Men and Johnny Blue Eyes? Do we think, yeah?
Put some together. You never know. You never know what might come out of this collaboration. No.
We're totally feeling the jewelry in the watch.
I want to see what you do with these guys.
I think we can accessorize.
What about the high heels? I think you look great in some of those guys, yeah?
Now it's time for
Big Brothers, Little Brothers, Big Answer, everybody. And we should have a caller on the line. Have we got Kelly there?
Hello,
Kelly. Hello, darling. What do you think of the nominations?
I'm quite shocked. Shocked about Sophia, actually, because she's been quite entertaining, but not so much about Halfwit.
Who are you going solitary fan? Who are you going to vote for?
I think probably for Sophia.
Right.
Really.
Okay. What's your question, by the way, darling?
I just wanted to know, Boyz II Men, if you had to recruit a new member, which housemate would it be?
You know what? I think it would probably be Halfwit.
Really?
Yeah. he got the Alex Vanderpool style.
He's got the preppy look. He don't have a voice, but we can kind of make that.
You can just get him to do some moves, man.
Plus, he's really rich, so he can fund the next record.
Yeah, okay. I like it. Lovely talking to you, darling. I hope that answers your question. Thank you, Kelly. What's our next question? I believe we've got... put that down. No? Forgive me the next one. Give me the next question. Thank you very much. We've got a text in from Brennig. It's for Johnny Blue Eyes. What is Johnny Blue Eyes' opinion on the way Chiron wears his trousers below his bum? Personally, I find it obscene. That's from Brennig.
Well, personally, I quite like that look, actually.
Really?
You know, when I walk down the street and I see men showing off their underpants with the trousers low, I think it's a good look.
What do we think about trousers underneath the bum?
Well, see, we're from Philadelphia, so in the United States, that's where it originated.
If you're going to rock your trousers below your butt, it's best to have on some fly undies, though.
Yes. Right, okay. You've got to make sure they're fresh as well.
They got to be clean and they got to look nice.
Gentlemen, what a pleasure talking to you. Please give my guests a massive round of applause. I will be back tomorrow night, 6 o'clock, right here on E4. And don't forget to watch the main show tonight at 10 o'clock on Channel 4. Until then, take care.